Some weird iPhone 7 leaks point to rumors we thought were buried. Android and Developer Preview gets some major updates today, and we continue to get more mixed information of the HTC 10. I'm Jaime Rivera, and if it's not the north side, then it must be the dark side. This is Pocketnow Daily. The official news today began with Amazon, as the company has just announced its new Kindle Oasis. The rumors were true. This is a very odd-looking Kindle that includes a case that also charges the tablet. The company's making a lot of fanfare over how thin this product is, how practical it is, etc. And it might as well, as the tablet is priced at $289. And actually, I meant e-reader, not tablet, e-reader, $289. You could buy a ton of 7-inch tablets for that price. Let's see what we get in the end. And for those of you that are concerned about USB Type-C cables, because these are very easy to find on Amazon for price tags that are probably subpar to the cost of these products, there are obviously a lot of concerns. Some of these wires were fake, etc., etc. So the forum has just decided to create this protocol that detects wires that are non-compliant. Problem is, we're not exactly sure how that's going to work. We're not sure if we're getting a software update that will allow current products to detect it, or if this is just something that'll come in the future. Stay tuned. We'll report back as we learn more. Now, a very interesting software update has just reached Android N in the developer preview, including bug fixes for multi-window support, in addition to the fact that you now get emojis that don't look like Slimer. For those of you that grew up with me watching Ghostbusters, you know what I'm talking about. Even better is support for Vulkan, which is OpenGL on steroids. Stay tuned, as we cannot wait to get Android N for everyone else. Now, even though so far our experience with the HTC 10 has been rather positive, we've got some very conflicting news about AT&T, mainly because the company hasn't really pronounced itself about supporting the HTC 10. We've heard every other carrier. T-Mobile even unboxed it on a helicopter. A lot of things are happening, and there's a lot to be excited about. This is a really good phone. Our review will be live very soon to tell you more. We just don't know what's happening with AT&T. Currently, HTC is recommending that you buy it unlocked if you want it on AT&T, and I'm actually testing it on the carrier, and it performs really well. And finally, the very hot news today have to do with the iPhone 7, iPhone 7 Plus. We've got more leaks that show us a very odd prototype in photos. Obviously, this might be just the Photoshop render, going back to the old Meizu design that we saw, but still, we hear that it's going to be the same dimensions as the iPhone 6S, 6S Plus. In addition, we hear that even though the 3.5mm headphone jack is going, apparently we won't be getting stereo speakers, which is very, very sad, and obviously we also hear about the dual camera. But it does lead me to the question of today. What design changes would you want to see on the iPhone 7? In my case, honestly, no more thin and lightness. How about a bigger battery? I would love that. Leave us a comment down below. We'd love to know your opinion. Friends, you know the way it goes if you want to get these news earlier before the video is filmed. Follow us on pocketnow.com and hit that subscribe button down below for more videos like this one. You can also catch our videos on Vessel at vessel.com/pocketnow and follow me on Twitter, Jaime_Rivera, or on Instagram at Jaime Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.